Today's recipe attempt will far and away be the most expensive, the most challenging, and probably the most time consuming. Will it be worth it? Let's find out. Welcome back to Bourdain.
Everybody should know how to use a knife.
Use everything, waste nothing. Let's start at the beginning.
It ain't that hard, okay?
I hope you're doing well. We are learning to cook with Anthony Bourdain's cookbook, doing every freaking dish. My name is Mitch May, and we're kind of just learning the craft here, doing everything for the first time on camera. So today we have chartreuse of quail, more like chartreuse of quail, little tiny freaking birds, deboning them and combining them with layers of foie gras, cabbage, and then it's gonna get drizzled with a nice little sauce and a garnish of a tiny little quail drumstick. It's a lot, it's a lot. I have Anthony Bourdain's book linked down below in the description as usual. Let's go.
All right, strap in. One essential flavor boosting onion. Half is going to be roughly chopped and half is going to be finely chopped. I'm not certain what Bourdain meant by this, so I went for a very fine dice and then I went over it again with my knife just to get it very, very fine. One carrot grown how it should be, AKA organic. We skin it, remove the top and roughly chop half of this and finely chop the other half. I think I found this from Julia Child. You thinly slice sheets and then slice those sheets lengthwise and you get the idea. Next, we need some cabbage. That's kind of like a sleeper for me as far as vegetables go. Bourdain asks for the leaves removed. I found it's easier to get leaves off of cabbage when you boil it for a bit. This has been going for about 5 or 10 minutes, and this is what we're left with. We take out the core and gently remove the outer leaves. The longer the cabbage boils, the more leaves will be tender. I just went for enough time so the first 4 or 5 are going to be tender. From here, a trick I learned making gwumpki, which is a Polish wrapped cabbage delicious treat. To remove this root is pretty essential for getting rid of excess fiber, really, that is not too palatable, not too sure how to say that. And removing this stem also allows us to wrap easier. Out of those 3 or 4 leaves, I'm sure at least 2 are going to be keepers. Bourdain calls for 1/2 cup of this cabbage to be shredded. I have a mandolin, but I am lazy and don't feel like cleaning another thing in this process, so I just go ahead with my knife and try to thinly slice as best as I can. Next, we get some solid country white bread. The goal is to slice these into 2 circles so they can fit inside of the ramekin. 1/2 inch per slice. I use the ramekin to kind of punch in a circle in the bread and then I carve it away with a knife. And we're left with 2 uncrustables. All this prep is making me hungry. I take this bread, which otherwise would not have been used, a little mustard, ham and classic Americano cheese, and a gherkin, which I freaking love. And I'm fueled up to finish this dish. Back to it, some finely sliced bacon. No, this is way too much bacon. Bourdain called for like a fraction of this and I just misread the recipe. I must have, because watching this, we have too much here, but I guess you can't have too much bacon. Looks good to me, and we transition to the hardest part of this recipe, deboning freaking quail. These things are just minuscule. I did not imagine them to be this tiny. First step, we have to remove the wingtips. They come off easy enough, and then we go after the wishbone, which is pretty simple. You cut a little slit on each side of the bone, which you can see, and then you stick your thumb and index finger in there, get around the wishbone, and it yanks right out. Next, we have to separate the joints of the wings from the rib cage or chest area. I'm not sure what the heck it is. I feel for that point of articulation in our tiny little bird friend, and I just shove my knife in there and cut away from me. Now the really difficult part. Bring this bird back and remove it from what nature intended with our fingers. Push it back kind of like a sock, rolling it outwards, being careful not to tear the skin. And I of course had to confer with the master Jacques Pepin, who makes this look easier than snapping your fingers. The goal is to now disjoint the thigh from the carcass. However, I failed to do so and the legs kind of just ripped out separate from the breasts. That's quite all right actually, because all we need are the breasts. And a very quote artsy fartsy thing Bourdain says you can do here is remove each individual drumstick and saute them to present with the finished dish. Of course, I'm going to try to do that. And as I'm working with this bird, it's actually kind of funny. I feel like I'm in a tiny kitchen working with these tiny little cute pieces of meat. Here is the finished product. We have the breasts removed, the cute little drumsticks removed, and the tenderloins, which are located inside of the bird. Over to a saute pan over medium heat, we season our fable-like poultry with salt. Add a tablespoon of butter, and I did glug a little olive oil just to make sure this butter doesn't brown super deeply. Our tiny little breasts are going to cook for 5 minutes, skin side down, of course. I did decide to add the little tenderloin pieces as well at this point. It's now time to roast what's left of the quail carcasses. They go in with our chopped onions and carrots, and a tablespoon of butter, massaging it thoroughly. I don't know if this is the way to do it, but it's going to go in the oven at 375 for about 1/2 hour until it gets nice nice and brown. Quail has cooked up nicely. We remove that and add our tiny little drumsticks to the pan as well. It took longer than expected to get some nice color on them, but eventually we get there in about 4 to 5 minutes and I pull them. We're gonna saute this bacon, the whole ungodly amount of it, over medium heat for about 3 minutes till we get nice and brown. I did notice that the pan got a little darker than I would have liked, so I added a little bit of our Madeira to deglaze the pan, along with the added effect of giving an amazing aroma to my kitchen. Once the bacon is browned, we add our finely diced onions and carrots and cook until nice and brown. This took about 4 to 5 minutes. We then add our cabbage, and this is going to cook nice and low and slow for about half an hour. I get this over to my tiny burner and just let that hang out. In the meantime, Bourdain says go back to your quail pan and deglaze with Madeira. I kind of wish he said this earlier because the pan was already hot. I had to reheat it, but regardless, we got some really nice flavor, which is going to add to our lovely sauce. We check on the bones. They are where I want them. We're going to deglaze this pan with some more Madeira. I'm sure you're finding a theme here. I needed to add a little more Madeira because we just want all this flavor that's stuck to the pan. Now in a clean saucepan, the bones and vegetables go in, along with our deglazed pan juice from the quail, making sure to get every little bit of that. Black peppercorns, one sprig of fresh thyme, 3 sprigs of parsley, and 1 magical bay leaf. And then we add 1 cup of chicken stock, which is actually duck stock, so can't go wrong there. Coming back to our roasting pan, I noticed we still got some flavor on here that we worked too damn hard for just to scrub off with soap. So I deglazed this with some extra duck stock. Yep, that is a lot of gelatin in there, and a little splash of our Madeira. Get this over high heat over both burners and get all those flavors into our sauce. We bring this sauce up to a boil, added a little water, and we let it simmer for about half an hour until it reduces by half. And now our cabbage mixture is looking phenomenal. There is a little added American flair with 10 pounds of bacon, but it's looking really good and I'm sure tasting better. Our stock sauce stuff has reduced and we strain that into a clean saucepan, and this stuff is the definition of savory. I've never seen anything like this. We bring this up over medium heat and then add 1 to 2 tablespoons of butter, and as if this couldn't get richer, we take foie gras, 1 ounce of the stuff, and whisk it in there as well. It didn't really mix too well. I actually had to strain the sauce again, which I didn't picture, but this is what we're left with. Probably a little too thick, demi-glace-like sauce. It's now time to assemble, which is just a lovely feeling. We have the carrot, cabbage, onion mixture. We have the leaves of cabbage along with our uncrustables. 2 ramekins, which we are going to brush with butter. Plop our cabbage leaf in here, and the idea, as Bourdain says, is to press it in and overlap it as if it is an oversized pie crust. For our other ramekin, I used 2 cabbage leaves, which actually worked out pretty well. About 2 tablespoons of our cabbage mixture will go in each of these, and now we get more freaking foie gras. 4 ounces of the stuff. Slicing it evenly, I let it come up to room temperature about, and then we layer this on top of the cabbage mixture. I'm curious as to how this will hold up in the cabbage, whether it will melt or kind of hold some sort of form. Once we have about 1/4-inch layer in each ramekin, we move on to our quail breasts. Bourdain says 2 per each ramekin, and I'm glad we sauteed up those little tenderloin bits because they kind of filled in the gaps here nicely. We now top this with more of our cabbage mixture, and we wrap these things. Not much instruction from Bourdain other than to make a cute little package, so I kind of just go 1 leaf by 1 leaf around in a circular fashion, and I noticed we had a little too much fiber going on, so I sliced that off and made sure we have a nice compact cabbage package. Cabbage. These are feeling impressively solid, like they're not gonna fall apart. And as recommended by Weight Watchers, we butter the uncrustables and place them inside the ramekin to finish this chartreuse of quail off. These then go in the oven at 325 for about 25 to 30 minutes. And while I'm waiting, that sauce, I can't get over it. I cannot help myself. I get a little piece of bread, dip it in there, and this was almost too savory. Frustratingly savory. I couldn't even fathom what I ate, but it is now time to plate. The bread has gotten nice and toasty. We take the ramekin and flip this thing, gently and delicately revealing our hard work. It's such an oddly satisfying looking thing. I decided to slice it. Probably should have let this rest, but I had to see what it looked like with a little cross section. For the plating, I actually did a riff off of a cake I saw a French chef do. He sliced it down the middle and he added some lovely sauce in between the 2 slices. This would not be complete without our minuscule little quail legs, and we hit it with some of the flaky salt because I don't know if anything else deserves this more. Second presentation, we gotta go for the black plate, of course, and it really looks good. This just looks really nice. Again, garnish with our teacup drumsticks, and we put the sauce around the chartreuse of quail. Now the most important part, how does this freaking taste? The foie gras, which I noted earlier, definitely just melted into this entire cabbage mixture. We get a little bit of everything for one big bite, and the flavor was amazing. There's no getting around it. It was absolutely incredible. However, I did feel this was actually too savory. There just wasn't a relief or pause from all of this heavy, delicious, unctuous, meaty flavor. I feel if the sauce had a little more acid to it, a little more bite, it definitely would have finished this better. And I do question the use of foie gras here. For me, it more so just adds a mouthfeel rather than actual depth of flavor. For example, chicken livers or beef. Granted, I don't have the palate of a French god, but I can't help but feel the price the animal had to pay, as well as my actual bank account, is a little excessive here. However, overall, I'm very pleased with this. I would think Bourdain would be happy. Thanks for spending your time with me. This was Back to Bourdain.